My name is Arnold Chin. I'm an assistant professor of urology at UCLA. And today we're in my laboratory at the Broad Stem Cell Center at UCLA. The goal of my lab is fairly, it kind of spans the gamut from basic research to translational research. Ultimately, we're trying to come with different angles, understanding basic biology of these disease processes, trying to identify weaknesses, and hopefully come up with novel therapeutics to try to translate and treat our patients. We're doing research on both prostate and bladder cancer.
So this is in an elevated temperature at 37 degrees Celsius, so it's kind of body temperature. So it allows cells and bacteria to grow in a more enriched environment.
For prostate cancer, we're looking at how inflammation regulates prostate cancer. We know that in prostate cancer, there's a lot of immune cells or inflammation within the prostate, but it's really unclear what that inflammation is doing. Another aspect of our research is in bladder cancer. And bladder cancer is one of the most expensive cancers to treat. And it's the fifth most common cancer in the United States, but there's actually little changes in the treatment for the last 30 decades. My brothers and I were all born in Connecticut, but I really grew up in Palo Alto, in the San Francisco Bay Area. When I went to college, I followed one of my brother's footsteps and I went to Princeton. And there I studied chemistry. When I was applying to medical school, I decided to apply to a joint MD-PhD program. It's an 8-year program sponsored by the National Institute of Health, where we do both a medical training as well as research training. I think all along, I knew I was interested in medicine and I love working with my hands. So as far as I can remember, I've always wanted to be a surgeon. I'm always taking apart things, putting them back together, or trying to put them back together.
The standard of care for a lot of our cancers is surgery. It can be from radiation, can be chemotherapy, can be surgery. This is an example, actually, of a patient of mine with a kidney tumor. These patients are very generous and actually have donated part of their tumor, which we would remove anyways for research purposes.
A big reason I became a scientist is all the unknowns. In life and in biology, looking back at all the questions we have in medicine and in biology, and the potential to make discoveries. Ultimately, as a physician and a scientist, I like to make a contribution and difference in the human condition. The life event that really changed me was my mother actually was diagnosed with breast cancer when I was in middle school. I was the youngest of three children, and she really held our household together. She's a cancer survivor. She's completely free of cancer for many years. My parents are not scientists per se, but my father is a chemical engineer. He worked at Stanford Research Institute doing developing technologies in polymers. And my mother, although she was trained in biology, spent her career in raising her family. What was important to me was finding a career and an opportunity that makes me excited every day. Our lab environment is very, I think it's very collaborative, it's a team approach, and it's very dynamic. Maybe a long time ago, labs are closed-off spaces when everybody had a small bench, a dark corner to work in. Our lab is what we call an open concept lab. We have many laboratories next to each other, and we all share common space, common equipment, common ideas. And so there's a lot of interaction, not only within my lab, but also amongst labs. And I think that's really how science is being performed these days. It's more of a team science approach. Every day is different. There's not a fixed schedule because science and experiments don't follow a 9-to-5 schedule. And I think that makes it exciting. The hopes and dreams of my research is really coming with novel therapies for patients with cancer. I think several decades ago, we treated all patients the same way. All patients got the same chemotherapy regimens, the same surgery. But I think now we really have to rethink how we treat patients, and it's really the era of personalized medicine. Personalized therapy meaning that we actually understand specific characteristics of the patient, of the disease, look at genomics of the cancer, and then we try to devise a set of treatments to really specifically target not only the cancer, but that cancer for that specific patient. When you make that big discovery, or you make any discovery, I think that can be very exciting. I think the day-to-day aspect of science is diverse. Every day is different for me. And that, in part, it really keeps us excited in doing what we do.